Alright, we're going to get started on the monocoating. We're going to monocoat the rudder first. Make sure your rudder is all sanded smooth, your joints are all good here with glue, so make sure your spark surface is clean. And you're going to want a good pair of sharp scissors, X-Acto blade, nice sharp blade, maybe a brand new one if you got one. If not, well, that's okay too, but it's a nice, smoother cuts and stuff with a sharp blade. A straight edge of some kind at some point. And a monocoating iron or a regular household iron works well. And to keep your iron clean, you want to keep the bottom of your iron very clean. I usually just spray some Windex down on a paper towel and rub it off that way. You don't want to transfer a color. I'm using yellow right here, but if I go to another color and I pick up an edge, I don't want to end up making the yellow smear onto another color or vice versa. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to start with the rudder. All right, the first thing you're going to want to do is roll out your monocoat to where you're going to cut it out. You're going to want some kind of weight or something like that just to hold the monocoat back. Place your part on the monocoat and just cut it out. You want about a half inch to a quarter inch to a half inch all the way around the outside edge. Hope this is all on film. And just cut that. I'm just going to cut it square basically. You want to get the most out of it that you can. So I'm just going to go around and trace the outside. And remember, we're doing the bottom part. So the part that's facing up is the tack paper. We're going to peel that off. And you're going to be able to just go ahead and use it from there. It doesn't have to be perfect to get around it, because you're going to trim most of it off anyway. Now, on any of the type backings that you use or colors that you use, you're going to have a backing you got to peel off. So peel off that backing. This can be fun sometimes. Lay that on there. That's about what we want. I'm just going to hold the edges and flip it right over. And basically all you're doing with this is every time you put a piece on anything, no matter what surface you're doing, you just tack the edges down, get it as flat as you can like this. You might want to hold the corners down like something like that when you do it. So I'm doing this side, and then I'm just going to lightly tack the edges all the way around the outside. I'm going to take a little touch. I don't know how they do it with a heat gun. If they do it with a heat gun and let it melt down, I've never used a heat gun before. I just use an iron. I get good results. I like it. But you're barely touching it, just enough to tack it on there. And once you tack all the outside edges, then it will shrink down the center. So you just want it to be as flat as possible. And if you wrinkle something up, don't worry about it. You can just heat it back up and pull it back off and put it back on again. So it's got some room for error, I guess you would say. But there, most of it's heated down to the edges. And then I usually pick it up and actually do the seam part, the back corner. And I'm going to put another piece on the other side, which is going to overlap it as well. So. And then I'm just going to cut the corners. I usually make a little tab so I can fold that tab down. And then I'll fold the tab down first and put this up. So I'm going to do the same thing over here. Put that. And then I just want to even it out a little bit. So I want to come across the bottom. That's easier to do with a straight edge or a knife. A little quicker. And I'm not going to need that corner. So I'll pop that out of there. And I'll save that to wrap around there. And the way I do corners, everybody does it a little bit different. I'm just going to pick about halfway up there. So this can fold up. And then I'm just going to come up here. On the other piece, I'll cut the opposite way. So now this piece here, I'll cut right across the top. Now that whole piece will cover the whole inside here. And this piece will come up, and you'll see there's a little gap right there. So the other piece I put on this side, I'll cut this part out, and so that one folds over to cover that part there. So there's a couple different ways to do things. At the top edges, you want to put some relief cuts in just so you can get at it. I follow the spar usually, follow the edge straight up, and that'll leave you the room for the tabs. I'm going to cut that right across. Alright, so I'm just going to go about now and kind of round the piece over. And you want to be careful, you don't want to overheat it, because if you shrink it too much, you'll warp it. So we're just tacking it in very lightly. You're going to see wrinkles as you go along. Just keep on going. They're going to come out as you go. So I'm going to just tack up all the edges. And then we'll trim it down. So now we've got some good edges going here. Feeling pretty secure that it's not going to shrink over the top of it when I go to shrink it down. So now I'm just going to barely even touch it. Just let the heat take care of it. As you can see, the wrinkles coming right out. Like I said, you just want to go quick with it because you don't want to warp the wood. You want everything laying flat on the table. And that's pretty much it. That's about it. So now I'm just going to go ahead and trim all these edges off. I just want to show you how I do the corners now. I'm pretty much going on. I didn't trim this one, so I can show you how I trim. But I trimmed all the edges off the top. But I went right across the surface of every piece. But the way I do the ends in the corner, is I just kind of fold one end down. Keep the end over. Just make it flat. And then I either cut it off, or I'm going to coat it down there. Basically it right there. And I'll do the same thing the other side. I'll usually take the outer edges and push them in and then take the main fat piece and bring it over the top. So basically that's all you're trying to do. Follow that little spar, just a little snip. You can bend that backwards to get it out of your way. And just fold this piece down. And then the best way to do it is just grab the corner and then just slide the piece toward you. And there we go. And we're going to do that all the way around the thing. And as you can see, it just seals it nicely. And then when you get to the top edge here, you just take a nice pair of sharp scissors. Hopefully these are sharp. I don't think they are. If you ever wrapped a Christmas present, basically you can just grab the top of it and slide it over. It should cut right nicely for you. It's sort of been very sharp. Something comes in handy. This is the part where the airons are, so I'm just going to roll right around the roll. Here, it's not a flat edge, so I just go with it. And seals that up nicely. I'm going to seal this in it. Just work your way right around, sealing up all the edges. And here I got a point. I'm just going to fold this back, and I'm going to try and maneuver this iron over, just to get the tip, round it over the tip, fold down the side. Well, first I got to get this top part, get that in there, and I'll roll this right over the top, just like we did the other sides. Take its shape. I'm going to trim the edge off this side now. And then once all your edges are sealed, you're just going to roll it right over everything until it seals it flat on the other side. Now when you go to do the other side, you don't have to worry about rolling over everything because you've already done this. You just put it flat on, cut the edge, seal it down. We'll be there in a second. It up. Make sure you can breathe out of the way. Just slightly touch it, that way you don't mar the monocoat. There's your monocoat piece on one side, all wrapped around, and then we'll do this side.